your sneak is really busted up. Well, I might know someone who could sort it out for you. His name's Fu An. He's an electronics nut. Nothing scares this guy. No job too difficult. Sounds like just the guy you need. Oh, geez, I haven't seen him in years. I don't even know if he's still alive. When I did know him, he used to have a little shop down in Kalasar. I don't remember the exact address, but you should be able to find it without too much difficulty.
What can I do for you? Depends. What do you want from him? Terrible state. I might be able to save certain objects from inventory. That good enough? It will cost you 400 sedex. I've transferred objects from Broken Sneak into your sneak. You need electronics? Come see Fuan. You need more? See Fuan. I'm the best and cheapest in all of Omicron.
Quenacola, the happiness drink. Health warning. Abuse of Quenacola can lead to the early destruction of your brain cells.
Please come.
it going, pal? Pick a booth. The most beautiful girls in Omicron are here, dancing nude just for you. Go ahead. You won't regret it. Anissa, she hasn't worked here for a while. She had an argument with the boss, and then she left. I think she dances in one of the bars on Kalazar Boulevard. I don't know which one. Hey, but I've got other girls here, real knockouts. Much better than Anissa. You ought to have a look.
Anesthetics.
Check for yourself. Everything's legal. I got nothing to hide. All right, no need to get excited. Anissa's that girl dancing over there.
I told you all I know.
You mustn't come back here questioning me. The boss keeps giving me dirty looks. I could get fired. It was 2 weeks ago. As usual, I was going home from work late when I heard a horrible scream coming from an alleyway. I was scared, so I hid. I've seen a lot of weird things at night, you know. Seconds later, a man came out of the alley. He was the police officer. He got up on his bike slider and disappeared. I went into the alley, and that's how I found the body. It was in a terrible state. There was blood everywhere, and... Yes, I'm sure. I recognized his uniform when he passed under a street lamp. I think he might have seen me. I'll never forget his eyes. They were red, like demons. There's something else. I didn't want to mention it the first time you and your partner came. You see, I was afraid I might get into trouble. I found a piece of paper in the alleyway. The murderer must have lost it in the confusion. I picked it up before the police came. Of course. I hid it in my dressing room. Give me a second to change. I'll show you the paper.
What'll it be?
How's it going, Kale? Anything new on Den's death? Well, you know you can count on me if you need any help. Hey, don't worry about it. Good luck, Kale. I really hope you make it.
Time to explain. Come to the apartment right away. Please, you've got to come. hell? I was so scared. A demon came here looking for you. He was really angry. He said he wanted your soul. Come here, please. Hold me in your arms.
Take me in your arms, darling.
I have come to warn you that your life is in terrible danger. You're wrong. This universe is just as real as yours. I know you're playing a video game in another dimension far away from here. But what you experience here is no game. It's reality. Our reality. And you risk your life every second. The demons are looking for you. They want your soul. You've already escaped from them several times. They're mad with rage. The demons get their evil force from people's souls. The more souls they have, the stronger they are. They take the souls to their master, Astaroth, and those souls are then damned for all eternity. The Omicron video game is a trap created by Astaroth himself. It's bait to attract the player's souls into our dimension. You would be damned for all eternity. In your dimension, your body would be no more than an empty shell, and your soul would be here in Astaroth's reservoir of souls, enduring infinite torment. The first thing to do is to destroy the gate the demons created between your dimension and ours. Otherwise, more players will fall for the trap as you did. And the demons will become so powerful that no one will be able to stop them. Astaroth put one of his lieutenants in charge of the gate. You will have to kill the Guardian to destroy it. Gandar is the Guardian of the gate. He had Kale murdered and sent you his body to capture your soul. He and his horde of demons are also responsible for the series of murders that Kale and Den were investigating before they were killed. You can access the gate through Gandar's office. You'll need a power rod to destroy it. It's the only way to annihilate a demon's work. You and Den found the only way to get there. All you have to do is follow the same route. A Yeshu monk awaits you in front of the supermarket in Zone 9. Show him the sign of the awakened, and he will lead you to someone who can help you. I can't tell you anymore for the moment. You must trust me. You have no choice in the matter, unless you want to burn in hell. To get into Gandar's lair, you must first know the door code. Gondar was careless enough to leave it at the scene of one of his murders. Anissa found it. You absolutely must get your hands on the code.
Thank you. Thank you.
investigating a series of unexplained murders for several weeks now. But we discovered something awful. The assassins. The demons. I know it sounds crazy, but they take the souls of their victims before they rip them to shreds and kill them. Because they look like humans, they can mix in with the general population, waiting for the right moment to attack. Their leader is a policeman. Commandant Gandar himself. I think they're on our trail. I think they know we've discovered the whole story. Our only hope is to find some kind of proof of their existence so that we can alert the authorities. Tonight, Kale and I are going out to bring back that proof. If something happens to us, Agent Tarek 511 is aware of our situation. He'll testify in our favor. May the Supreme Being have pity on our souls.
And the fallen angels took to flight, transformed into fierce beasts, and fell upon their prey. I didn't know Den had left such a poignant message before dying. So nice of you to bring back the cassette for me. I do so hate leaving traces behind. You're smarter than you look, but maybe just a little too smart. You were becoming an embarrassment. You even had the guts to enter Gandar's lair. My master ordered me to take your souls. After his death, Kale's body was sent into another dimension to trap the soul of a video game player. Your soul. One of my brothers was supposed to collect it as soon as it returned to Omicron, but you escaped. Now the time has come to correct that little error. A game? Do I look like a game? Everything you see around you is real. Your computer is just a gateway to our world. Your body is still in your world, but your soul has been here ever since you agreed to occupy Kale's body. You think you're safe behind your computer screen? You better think again. I will take your soul. You will die and be damned for all eternity. Come, little human. Come and play with me.
again? I'm fed.
Thank you.
One who holds the fate of Omicron in his hands. You are courting great peril, Nomad Soul. I hope you can save this universe from the hell of chaos. Accept this modest gift. 3 interlinking rings. The first 2 will save your life. The 3rd will bring you back here.
Got something that belongs to me, and I'd like to get it back.